On behalf of Bendigo Senior Secondary College, I would like to officially welcome you all to this very special occasion, our 2022 graduation ceremony. Please thank Uncle Paul Chapman for opening our ceremony. My name is Sam Graham, and along with Inez Harrington, we'll be your hosts for this evening. I would now like to welcome Rafaela Musk and Amelia Leach to say the acknowledgement of country.
Good evening. My name is Raf and this is Amelia. Before we begin tonight's ceremony, we would like to acknowledge and honour that we are meeting on Jarra country. We extend our appreciation to the Jarjarrung people, the traditional owners of the land on which we stand. We acknowledge that sovereignty has never been ceded and this always was and always will be Aboriginal land. We pay our respects to leaders and elders, past, present and emerging. They hold the memories, traditions, culture and hopes of all Jarjarrung people. We would also like to extend this acknowledgement to all Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people here with us tonight.
In the last few months, our mob has experienced significant loss in the passings of both Uncle Archie Roach and Uncle Jack Charles, And tonight we would like to honour them as they both pass on, and we thank them for the work they have done for all Indigenous people and how they have also strengthened allyship and fought for us to have a more equal future by paving the way for us all, which is seen tonight through their continuing efforts to achieve self-determination, reconciliation and the current efforts for treaty and an Indigenous voice to Parliament. As we, the graduating class of 2022, leave today and emerge as future leaders and elders of the country, honour and respect the country you are on, and also honour your own people and ancestors as you go forwards from today. To the class of 2022 graduates, congratulations.
Thank you, Raph and Amelia. My name's Innes Harrington, and it's my pleasure to be one of your hosts for this evening's graduation ceremony. I'd now like to introduce our language students to welcome us in their languages of study.
Hi, my name's Indy and I study Chinese. 欢迎光临本地的高中2022毕业典礼。
Hello everyone, my name is Chelsea Parilia and I studied English as an additional language. And today we welcome you all to Batch 2022 graduation ceremony. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Mason Bennett and I study French. Nous vous souhaitons à tous les bienvenus à notre cérémonie de remise des diplômes 2022.
Hello everyone, my name is Molly Hurd van Emmerich and I study German. Wir heißen euch alle zu unserer Abschluss willkommen.
Hello everyone, my name is Gemma and I study Indonesian. Kami menyebut kalian di upacara wisuda 2022.
We would like to welcome our special guests present this evening, our Principal, Dale Pearce, College Council President, Damien Tangi, and College Council representatives, School Special College Guest, Neil Taylor, Regional Director, Angela Singh, Area Executive Director, Anne Cunniff, Senior Education Improvement Leader, Stephen Brain, La Trobe University Associate Professor, Craig Deed, Principal of Aruna College, Bendigo, Jason Bysouth, Principal of Bendigo South East Secondary College, Glenn Donald, parents and family members, Bendigo Senior Secondary College staff, and very importantly, our Year 12 graduating students for 2022. To commence our ceremony this evening, for those who would like to, we now invite you to stand for the Australian National Anthem performed by Sonny Hannaford and accompanied by Yankvin Ross on piano.
Thank you, Sonny and Yangfeng, for performing our national anthem. Our first guest this evening is Bendigo senior alumni Ryan Peterson. Ryan is the 2022 Youth Premier, 2021 and 2022 Deputy Youth Mayor of the City of Greater Bendigo and was the Youth Mayor in 2020. He's currently studying a Bachelor of Planning at La Trobe University. Ryan has been a voice for the young people of Bendigo Senior, Greater Bendigo and the State of Victoria. He's been a member of the 2020 and 2022 Victorian Youth Parliaments advocating for sustainable building standards, stronger pathways for medical practitioners in regional Victoria. Ryan is also a founding member of the City of Greater Bendigo Youth Council, which started in 2019. In the past 5 years, Ryan has worked to reduce youth unemployment in Greater Bendigo, increase local government support for LGBTQIA+ community members, improve local education pathways, raise awareness for regional health services, and ensure that young people are listened to and respected as members of our community. Ryan was the Bendigo Senior Florence Anderson Award recipient in 2017 for services to the life of the college, after being a member of the now student representative team and a student representative on the College Council. Ryan is a valued member of our alumni community, and we're thrilled to have him speak with us this evening.
Thank you, Ennis. About 5 years ago now, I was sitting where you are now and wondered which company I'd be working at as a car designer. Thought I might weasel my way into Ferrari or Lamborghini. As you can tell, it didn't quite pan out because I was, if anything, too focused on that impossible dream. Had I kept going down that path, I would have never sat in the seat of the Premier of Victoria or debated in Parliament House. I doubt I would have ever been able to do something as simple as meet the Mayor of Greater Bendigo. I spent so long on a single aspiration that I couldn't see I was leaving behind so many other opportunities. It took me a failed design diploma, a pandemic, multiple jobs, and years of youth leadership to figure out that I wanted to apply for a course at a university 5 minutes from my house. I know alumni who are asked back to speak at events like this have reputations of being high-flying students, to have the time to volunteer in the community and be global citizens. I graduated from VCE with an ATAR of 55. Not even scaling from English language or German could save me. But I scraped through and went on in search of the next big thing. It turned out to be town planning. Can't help but feel like I made a wrong turn somewhere, but someone needs to have a say in how our towns and cities grow and change to meet the needs of a growing population. And like so many other occasions, I decided I was the best person for the job, even though I have no real plan of how I'll do that. All I know is that I want to help change things and do some good. Since graduating in 2017, I've collected a few minor accolades, which you've already heard about. You might wonder what it takes to achieve those sorts of positions. You need just one thing: a desire to push yourself and learn from your opportunities. It's human nature to want to progress and wonder what's next. Plan for the next short-term goal and work towards it. I've never been ready for an opportunity, but I've known it's something that I wanted to do. In one way or another, I have this school to thank for that mindset, for being able to sit in on meetings with important people and embarrass them or myself by being overly direct or talking too much. But that's what I felt I had to do. I had to be brash and get to the point because it's the only way I saw anything getting done. In my experience, that's just being a very outspoken young person. That's just how it is. But it's also the knowledge that your life, all 18 or so years of it, is valuable, is worth sharing, and worth taking notice of. Life experiences, and the more you talk about it that way, the wiser you become. Whenever I go into a meeting or sit down to talk to someone, I like to think, what can I give you that you wouldn't get from anyone else? The screenwriter Aaron Sorkin once said, decisions are made by those who show up. If you go through your life knowing that you can give your knowledge, your services, and lived experience, you grow as a person, and everything around you will grow as a result. For all of you, the next 5 years will be a balancing act of friends, family, self, and success. So here are a few small notes from me. Take care of yourself more than anything else. Always look for short-term opportunities and don't lose yourself in the long-term pursuit of a dream. Speak up, because sometimes people need to hear the things that they are the least willing to listen to. Don't fake it till you make it. That attitude is the birthplace of imposter syndrome. Know your worth and never doubt the value of your contributions to anything. All good speeches seem to end with quotes, so here's one of my favourites from anthropologist and writer Margaret Mead. Never doubt that a small group of thoughtful, dedicated people can change the world. It's the only thing that ever has. Thank you.
Thank you, Ryan, for your inspiring words. We hope that you've had a chance to look through your graduation booklet, where you will see the names of all the Year 12 students who are completing their secondary education at Bendigo Senior this year. Tonight, we will be acknowledging those students who are able to be here as they come across the stage. Various photos will be taken throughout the night, and we will advise via Compass how you can access these. As we have many students being presented tonight, we ask that you hold your applause until the end of each segment. Please now re-welcome our principal, Dale Pierce, who will be making the presentations to our graduates this evening. I'd now like to introduce Student Engagement Coordinator, Hamish Bolton.
Thank you, Innes. It is my pleasure and privilege to announce the first group of graduating students present here tonight. I would also like to welcome to the stage Year 12 Assistant Principal Lauren Martin, who will assist Dale. We congratulate the following students: Maddie Ahern, Zoe Aldridge, Grace Alfred Coolin, Luke Anderson, Emily Anderton, Izzy Anthony, Lockie Appleby, Hunter Austin, TJ Austin, Shana Avard, William Aylmer, Aidan Baldwin, Ella Baldwin, Olivia Baldwin, Asya Balki, Lily Barley, Layla Bartolo, Jenna Barton, Laura Bowden, Harvey Beale, Riley Beard, Eve Beadle, Dermot Bell, Madison Bell, Cheyenne Bell, Mason Bennett, Abby Bentley. Amber Bainon. Montana Biggs. Amy Billsborough. Mirabai Bertels. Lucy Black. Kalia Bonanno. Kayla Burke. Gabby Bovard. Maeve Bowman. Jackson Brennan. Naya Britz. Caitlin Brown. Hannah Buchan. Hayley Burnclay McMahon. Ebony Butcher. Charlie Cairns. Madeline Cameron. Zoe Cameron. Caitlin Campbell. Ruby Candy. Bowen Couch. Jazz Chambers. Jessica Chisholm. Crystal Clark. Toby Clark. Jay Coates Moore. Haley Coe. Giselle Cole. Montana Collier. Emma Como. Indiana Cooper. Joseph Corcoran. Amy Cornfoot. Haley Costalunga. Asha Coulson. Jazz Coulson. Sarah Creevy. Dakota Cumming. Grace Cunningham. Macy Kerno. Shanae Curran. Noah Davies. Holly Davis. Liam Deacon. Georgia Dean. Octavia Di Donato. Hudson DeMarco. Max DeMarco. Thomas Dillon. Liv Douglas. Ruby Draper. Emily Dunstan. Tom Dynan. Lily Edsel French. Kendra Edwards Smith. Ben Elkington. Audrey Ellis. Jesse Ingerfield. Blake Fallon. Alicia Field. Arabella Finlay. Crystal Fisher. Yeah. Chloe Fleming. Isaac Fofana. Zaren Fong Sutton. Jordan Franks. Madison Fry. Keely Fullerton. Reese Giddies. Michaela Giafrelli. Anique Gould. Jack Goulin. Josie Gower. Isabel Gray. Jai Brickricks. Matisse Grills Marsili. Sunday Guest. Ethan Gutteridge. Charlotte Hare. Joshua Hancock. Astrid Harding. Lydia Harding. Parker Harding. Bella Harrick. Chloe Harrop. Nikki Harris. Edward Harrison. Maddie Hart. Grace Hayes. Molly Hurd Van Emmerich. Albie Hinchie. Georgia Henderson. Patrick Henderson. Penny Hendy. Polly Hickson. Laura Higgins. Louise Hocking. Austin Hollingsworth. Jordan Holt. Zach Horsfall. Tyler Howard. Kuyaya Tu. Georgia Hufa. Baden Hunter. Hannah Hutchins. Millie Jackson. Judd Ibsen. Anika Jackson. Edward Jenkin. Bella Jensen. Lily Johns Hayward. Alia Johnson. Riley Johnston McLeod. Asher Joyner. Sonia Kay. Tyson Keneally. John O'Keating. Ben Corrali. Harry Knight. Congratulations to all students who have just been presented, and thank you to Dale and Lauren. It is my pleasure to now introduce Sonny Hannaford and Carlo Davis to sing Say a Little Prayer. They will be accompanied by Hanley Rourke and Ethan Teasdale.
Please thank Sonny, Carlo and Hanley and Ethan for their wonderful performance this evening. I now welcome back to the stage Dale Pearce and Student Engagement Coordinator Kendall O'Sullivan to present our next group of graduating students.
Thank you, Sam. It is my absolute pleasure to announce the next group of graduating students present here tonight. I welcome to the stage Student Engagement Coordinator Kate Kelly, who will assist Dale. We congratulate the following students. Kayla Lordigas. Thank you. Ali Larson. Zali Lau. Amelia Leach. Kayla Ledwidge. Connor Lee. Mitchell Lead. Louise LaCastro. Isabella Locke. Mats Lodewicks. Kiera Long. Xander Ludeman. Riley Lithgow. Bianca Moritz. Olivia Masters Migliore. Toby McCaig. Molly McCarthy. Chloe McClure. Esther McCronin. Arnon McKinnon Foley. Briley McLeod. Tim McNaughton Perry. Grace Meeser. Taylor Mitchell. Tamika Monks. Brianna O'Brien. Shalina Maroney. Nicola Morton. Charlotte Mundy. Zali Muscatello. Caleb Nancaro. Mook Nanthaboon. Tilly Neal. Hayley Neve. Acacia Nemeth. Leah Nichols. Ashlyn Nisbet. Alkira O'Sullivan. Poppy O'Dwyer. Jess Panneras. Charlie Parker. Chelsea Parilia. Freya Pierce. Lily Pierce. Luke Peck. Caitlin Phillips. Jake Phillips. Jay Pickering. Thea Pilkington. Siali Pitson, Caleb Pope, Liv Pope, Declan Pridham, Tara Pridham, Tom Purcell, Deani Ralph Pryor, Madison Randall, Kaya Regan, Jake Reed, Taya Reed, Thomas Reed, Indy Rich, Jordan Rimmer, Jazzy Roberts, Riley Roberts, Tiana Robinson, Cooper Rook, Jeanette Ross, Kate Russell, Shamika Russell, Cohen Ryan, Madison Ryan, Luke Salvador, Chelsea Sanders, Abby Satori, Ethan Saville, Gracie Schindler, Tori Cicluna, Eliza Scott, Abby Seward, Matthew Sexton, Ethan Sharp, Liam Shepherd, Oliver Shuri, Rhea Simmons, Lottie Simpson, Phoebe Skinner, Abe Sladden, Lily Smith, Ruby Southern, Hugh Stanley, Miller Stevenson, Thomas Stone, Ryan Stubbs, Jordan Suter, M. Swain, Zane Taylor, Ella Thompson. Harriet Thompson. Job Thompson. Shayla Thompson. Jasmine Tolley. Demi Tongzing. Scarlett Town. Chloe Triplett. Sunday Tully. Jesse Turnbull. Alana Zaros. Jaska Uren. Indy Waghorn. Marcus Waghorn. Jet Vandenberg. Acacia Ward. Millie Hornest. Tyler Wastell. Murphy Watson. Nicholas Wellman. Jude Wheelhouse. Bailey White. Mia White. Georgie Whitfield. Ben Wingington. Joe Wild. Eliza Wilkinson. Danielle Williams. Casey Wills. Rihanna Wing. We congratulate the following students. Congratulations to all the students who have just been presented, and thank you to Dale and Kate. We also thank all advisors for the great support you have provided to our students throughout the year. Wayne Cox. Diane G. Renee Rodder. Mary Nash. Marcus Patching. Peter Adams. Joy Rester. Matt Callow. Cindy Grocott. Sue Maylard. Kate Kelly. Yes, Thank you. I would now like to welcome Kylie Hand and Dan Gibbons to the stage, who will introduce our Net School graduates.
It's my pleasure to congratulate the following Net School graduates. Willem Edlin. Rachel Hamilton and River. Lilith Rowe. Loz Woodman. I would also like to thank the Net School mentors and assistant Judy Stewart, who have supported our students. Jim Cowie. Emma Smart. And Judy Stewart. Congratulations to all students who have been presented here this evening.
Please thank Dan Gibbons for presenting our final group of graduating students for this ceremony. Thank you also to Ash Bird, Christina Finch, and our music students for providing the wonderful entertainment tonight. I now invite our principal, Dale Pearce, to make his graduation presentation.
Thanks, Innes, and I've got a speech here before me, but before I start, I just want to say what a wonderful opportunity and how proud we were to have Uncle Paul here with us this evening to start us off on the didge. I'm one of Uncle Paul's failed didgeridoo students this year, but it's wonderful that we could have him here and a great honour for us, so we thank him again. We're gathered here this evening to acknowledge the achievement of our Year 12 students in reaching the conclusion of their formal secondary education. And I want to acknowledge the presence here this evening of our parents and all of the family members who have joined us, because your support, your direction and your love has shaped and will continue to shape your son or daughter far more than the capacity of this or any other school. I know how proud you will be of your children this evening, but I also know students won't be the only ones here tonight who are both nervous and excited about what lies ahead. That's something that you'll share with them. Schools and individual teachers too, of course, have played their part in preparing these young men and women for life. And it's my great privilege to stand here this evening, as I do every year, on behalf of all of the schools and all of the teachers who have contributed to the lives and education of these young people during their progression from a small, smiley-faced little preppy to what you see here before you this evening. And they've looked fantastic. Of course, this group of students has endured all sorts of challenges with COVID, but at least 2022 has been a little more like normal, and we're all really pleased about that. All of our VCE and VCAL students have invested years of time and effort to get to this point in their journey. And over the coming years, the world is going to open up before all of them. Their success is going to depend as much on the type of person they become as it will on the results they take away from this or any other school. For VCE students, of course, exams lie ahead over the next few weeks and then the nervous wait for results. And while some of those students may get a surprise, for the most part, we know that students will that their results are going to reflect the results that they've been getting throughout the year. And students will, of course, naturally have lots of different expectations and plans for the future. Our VCAL students too have worked really hard to set themselves up for success and their pathway, whether that's to TAFE, whether it's to apprenticeship or work. And the skills and capabilities you've developed will provide the basis for your success in your future as well. I always think the size and nature of our school means that we'll have great diversity amongst our students, and I think we've seen that here tonight. And an important part of the education we provide is the opportunity to mix with others who are different to you in some way. because that's what your future is going to hold. Be aware always of who you are, be proud of where you've come from, but also appreciate the difference in others. If everyone did that, we'd live in a better world. All of our graduating students will have choices to make. Please make them good ones. Your local community, our state, our country, and the world at large is shaped by what every individual thinks and does. And we know how passionate and how driven this generation can be. Please don't ever lose that passion or that desire to do good, not just for yourself, but on behalf of others. We're a society, not just a collection of individual people, and what you say and do matters. So no matter where your future takes you, we wish you well, and we hope that you'll live a rich and really fulfilling life and look back with great fondness on your time here at our college. Congratulations once more to all of our graduating students, and thanks again to parents and guests for your attendance here tonight. Thank you. I want you to now, or I invite you now, to turn your eyes to the screen for a really special presentation for tonight's graduating students.
Fall is here, hear the yell, back to school, ring the bell, brand new shoes, walking blues, climb the fence, books and pens, I can tell that we are gonna be friends, yes I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Walk with me, Susie Lee, through the park and by the tree, we can rest upon the ground and look at all the bugs we found. Safely walk to school without a sound. We safely walk to school without a sound. Well, here we are, no one else. We walk to school all by ourselves. There's dirt on our uniforms from chasing all the ants and worms. We clean up and now it's time to learn. We clean up and now it's time to learn. Numbers, letters, learn to spell, nouns and books and show and tell. Playtime, we will throw the ball, then back to class, through the hall. Teacher marks our height against the wall. The teacher marks our height against the wall. We don't notice any time pass, 'cause we don't notice anything. We sit side by side in every class. The teacher thinks that I sound funny, but she likes it when you sing. Tonight I'll dream in my bed while silly thoughts run through my head of the bugs and alphabet. And when I wake tomorrow, I'll bet you and I will walk together again. 'Cause I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Yes, I can tell that we are gonna be friends.
I may tell you to run. On the way. On the way. out my hand. I may see you, I may tell you to run. The day began, I called a rest, a frantic beating in my chest, a panicked reeling in my brain, perspective lost but nothing gained. I was so stuck inside my shell, then the ground began to sway. I realized what mattered most to me. When the stars began to fall right out in the sky and the seas were rising up, I had one thing in mind. It was you, it was you, it was you. It was you, it was you, it was you. When the road began to crumble in front of my eyes, there was only one person I wanted to find. It was you, it was you, it was you. It was you, it was you, it was you. The precious moments that we shared, you slowed time down inside my head. I wish I'd found this clarity while I still had you close to me. But I was stuck inside my shell until the ground began to sway. I realized what mattered most that day. When the stars began to fall right out of the sky and the seas were rising up, I had one thing in mind. It was you, it was you, it was you. It was you, it was you, it was you. When the road began to crumble in front of my eyes, there was only one person I wanted to find. It was you, it was you, it was you. It was you.
I'd like to welcome back to the stage our Year 12 Student Leadership Team leaders for 2022, Kieran Noble, Mohammed Khan and Elise Laidlaw-Greeley, to respond on behalf of our Year 12 students.
Thank you, Sam. What a ride. To say that we have graduated in 2022 is no mean feat. Riding on the back of a pandemic, we have finished Year 12, one of, if not the most important, years of our lives to date. Learning through COVID was tough, and is most certainly a low point in my life. For many of us, COVID meant fear, lack of motivation, loneliness, loss of opportunity. Certainly not the ideal way to begin Year 12. The stress of the last few years was sadly not something that immediately dissipated as the new year ticked over. And Year 12 isn't exactly the most relaxing year. As much as we would love to forget these last few years, I would like to ask each and every one of you over the next few weeks to reflect on your time as a student at BSSC. To remember your struggle and to consider what an immense achievement that making it through Year 12, let alone Year 12 in 2022, is. With this achievement in mind, I hope that we can begin this next phase of our lives with the understanding that when we dig deep and push forward, we can get through challenging times and make the most of our situation. Though many people, myself included, tend to stress about Year 12 achievement, if anything is a marker of success, it is the qualities you have exhibited over these past few years. We observe teamwork, kindness, empathy, courage, and determination, attributes that will hopefully contribute to our continued success. I've had the pleasure of meeting and getting to know what feels like a lot of you, yet walking across this stage today with so many faces I didn't recognise. The small bunch of students who I have come to know is just a sample of the many wonderful people sitting in the audience tonight, every one of whom is a completely unique person, a person who is able to do something in the world in a way that no one else can. Though we are such different people, one thing I've learned during my time at BSSC is that no matter the differences in our paths or the approach we take to our lives, we are stronger together. something that has been proven many times over these past 2 years. So thank you to the class of 2022 for being so tough and pushing through these 2 years alongside me and alongside each other. The potential in this room is undeniable, and I cannot wait to see where you all end up. Congratulations, class of 2022.
Thank you, Kieran. On behalf of all the Year 12s, we would now like to focus our appreciation on our parents, carers and other important people who have supported us throughout not just this final year, but the 12 preceding them as well. Without your guidance, encouragement and stability, we would not all be here today. Truly, our graduation is as big of an achievement for you as it is for us. Whether it was picking and dropping us up from school, asking about how our assessments went, listening to us stress over homework and exams, or simply providing a place for us to recharge and do it all again tomorrow, we sincerely thank you for the effort you have made for us and our educations. To say that our years of high school were improved by you guys is an understatement. Our parents, guardians, and whole support systems have been the force that pushed us towards studying for the next SAC or preparing for the next assessment, even when we were tired of it. You motivated us to succeed. And I'm sure we have all heard the African proverb, it takes a village to raise a child. And on behalf of the Year 12 cohort, I would like to thank our villagers for everything that you have done for us. We hope you know how much we appreciate the time and sacrifices you have put into our lives and our education. We could not have done this without you.
Thank you, Elise. Graduates, family members, and staff, it is an honour for me to be here tonight and extend my greetings and gratitude to all teachers and staff. As we scrutinise the importance of this very momentous event, an event I believe is very important and plays a significant role in the symbolism of change and progression of us moving into our own adventures. It tells us that today is not just a day that we are celebrating our achievements, but perhaps more importantly, a day we express our gratitude to the people behind the success, a tribute to the teachers and staff here at BSSC. Thank you to all our staff who put forth immeasurable effort to create a tidy and organised atmosphere so we could perform at our full potential. Thank you to the career advisors who assisted us in moving forwards into our next stages of life. To the wellbeing team for supporting us during this very emotional journey. And thank you to all the other staff members. Last but not least, I'd like to thank you, all the staff, all the teachers for their assiduous care for us. We depart from the school with not just the knowledge and skills that they have given to us, but the valuable life lessons and skills, as well as ethics and inspiration as we step into the world that lies ahead. We sincerely appreciate everything that you have done, to prepare us thus far for examinations, as well as supporting us through moments of uncertainty. Thank you. And we will always be indebted to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Kieran, Muhammad, and Elise. Innes and I would also like to congratulate all students on your achievements this year and wish you well for your exam. We thank you all for your involvement in our ceremony tonight and welcome back Dale Pearce to conclude our ceremony.
Thanks, Sam. I've got a few housekeeping things to run through, but before I do, can I just ask everybody here, students, not you, but all of the parents, all of the family members, all of the staff, all of our special guests, to once more put your hands together and congratulate our graduating class of 2022. Thank you to Sam and Innes, our student hosts. Thank you to our performers. Thank you to our special guests, our families, and of course to our students. I'd like to extend a big thank you to the team of staff who helped plan this ceremony, in particular to Lauren, to Joe, and to Danielle, and our support staff who assist in all of that work. As I said earlier, a very special thanks to Uncle Paul Chapman for the ongoing support he provides to the college as well as his involvement in tonight's event. I'd like to also thank our communications team, John Holton, Paul Galaska and Jenny Milberg, for the photos they've taken this evening, and just remind you that those will be available via a link that we'll distribute to you shortly, and we'll notify you of that through the Compass portal. For those students who would like to have a student photo taken in academic gowns, please make your way to the Stratagem studio when we finish here. And I'll remind you that we're really looking forward to our Year 12 Last Day celebrations tomorrow. It'll run from 9 till 11:30 when we will gleefully return duty of care back to your parents and carers. I want to encourage all students, you will have seen my message to you this morning, or most of you will have, but I want to remind you again and encourage you to celebrate the end of classes safely, and for our VCE students in particular to maintain their focus on exams over the next month. I want to wish again our Year 12 students all success in achieving a positive and sustainable pathway for 2023, whether that's to university, whether it's to TAFE, work or some other form of training. I hope that all of our families can enjoy some family time together tonight where you can really reflect on the great achievements as a family and getting to the end of secondary schooling. It's a big journey, and I know that as a parent you'll be here tonight feeling that this has been a long haul, and I know how proud you'll be of your children. Can I please ask, as you do leave us this evening, to please make sure that you leave via the courtyard rather than the front gates, because there's a horde of people jamming up against those waiting to get in at 7 o'clock or a little bit after 7:15, we're going to let them in. So we need to ask you to make sure you go out via the side doors as you leave, next to the cafe, not the front steps. And I'd like you to please stay just for a few minutes. Fantastic performance from our students before. We've got some wonderfully talented musical students here, and we're going to enjoy another performance, just a final musical item by Sonny Hannaford, Kalo Davis, Alana Jurisic Hall, Jonah Zock, Ethan Teasdale, Hanley Rourke and Nathan Edwards, with a little Elton John medley. Best wishes, and please enjoy the rest of the night, everyone. Thank you.